Is it time to switch to an electric vehicle?
Yeah, so there are some Blink stations here at Balboa Park. They're all empty right now. So, hey, if anybody needs to charge a car, this is a good place to come by. You'll see around town, this is growing infrastructure. There's plenty of charging companies. Blink is one, EVgo, Volta, ChargePoint. So many different companies. They have different price points as well. Let's see, this one, you can click on the rates here. This one's 49 cents per kilowatt hours. You also notice there are different actual types of chargers depending on your car. So a lot of research that needs to be done, but why do people want EVs? Well, it mostly comes down to the price that you're paying at the pump. Gas prices have gone a bit down since the state rolled out its winter blend early, but they are still way beyond the national average. These are the latest numbers from AAA nationally. A gallon of regular cost, about $3.58. California's average is $2 more at $5.58 a gallon. And in San Diego, we are paying $5.76. So the question is it cheaper to charge an electric vehicle? It's nuanced, but I spoke to some folks who study this topic to find out. The executive editor at Auto Trade magazine says one factor is whether you plug in at home or at one of these charging stations.
In the end, you're probably going to save a little bit of money on the fuel costs by having an electric car versus a gasoline-powered car. It depends on the cost of electricity. In San Diego, electricity can be expensive. So you may end up being a break even, or it may be saving you a little bit of money. It's not going to be any kind of gigantic savings, because at the end of the day, you have to pay to power your car one way or the other.
All right, so take a look at your screen. This map shows some of the more than 1,700, quite a few of them, public charging stations in San Diego County. According to PlugShare, the company that actually provides this data to the county, 142 of these stations are free. Can't beat that, right? If you're charging at home, though, SDG&E says you may pay more on your electric bill, but that company says it is typically less than the monthly cost that you'll pay at the pump. And SDG&E also says it offers different electric vehicle pricing plans, which include lower rates when you charge overnight and not during those peak hours like 4 to 9 p.m. I met Corin Ansley at his home in Claremont. There he is right there. His home already had a solar panel, which made it all the more easier to make the decision to go electric. And he says not having to deal with gas prices has been a plus. So to expand on that, just how nice it is to not have to pay for any gas right now when you're seeing the prices at $6 a gallon.
Oh, yeah. My mother-in-law will talk about filling up the tank and having it cost, I don't know, close to $100 or something. I'm like, well, I paid $13. So it definitely feels nice with the prices rising.
All right, so tonight we're going to break down through the next 12 hours some of the questions you may want to ask before making that switch that he did. Coming up at 5:30, the hesitations when you're buying an electric vehicle and whether or not the offered incentives make it worthwhile. Back to you in the studio for now, Kimberly.
Yeah, we look forward to those questions coming up. So important. Thank you, Ole.